What's up everyone and welcome to Ola Testing Sh**. Today I'm trying out the new Mesa Rectifier Badlander amplifier. You guys know me, I am a huge fan of the dual rectifier. It was my first real tube amplifier back during the 90s. It holds a very, very special place in my heart. So when Mesa told me that they were making a new modern rectifier, it's a done deal. I purchased one. And it looks like this. Look at this. Classic plate right here, black plate there. The amp head is a little bit more compact than a regular dual rectifier head shell right there, but you're getting two channels. It's a 100 watt amplifier with EL34 power amp tubes in it, but there's also a quick bias for 606. I have to try that out in a separate video. You have two channels with three different modes. You have clean, crunch, and crush. A very straightforward layout right here with master, presence, bass, mid, treble, and gain. It has a built-in cab clone in it. It means that you can use this head without having a speaker load or a speaker connected to it. And you can use headphones or the direct output at the back to record straight into the audio interface. No need for a power attenuator. They come preloaded with Mesa's IRs, but you can also load in your own IRs, which I'm definitely gonna do. I'm using this guitar going straight in to the Mesa Rectifier Badlander. That goes into my 4x12 Mesa standard cabinet. That's a Neumann TLM 102 over there. That's an Austrian Audio OC18. And I have a LeWitt room microphone over there. And that is the single path of this demo. So here we go. Standby off. Yes! Right now I'm using the channel 2 in crunch mode. That is so nice. I mean, usually with the dual rectifiers, you know, it's a classic, it's an old design. But to get a very saturated push and a metal tone in the dual rectifier, you either needed an overdrive or to use active pickups on your guitar. But here, man, this is a modern sounding rectifier right here. All right, oh shit, man, that makes me so happy. Okay, let's try out the different tone knobs here. So gain is obviously the most powerful control on this amplifier, but just like on the standard rectifier models, you know, all of these tone controls are somewhat connected to each other. So, you know, one knob will affect the overall tone and how the gain kind of works and sounds. So, So we have gain at 12 o'clock right now. Let's adjust the treble. That's a good chunk right there, okay? That's what I tell you. Okay, let's go to the crush mode, see what happens. I think the crush channel is made for lead playing. It has a lot of gain. Let's just turn it up to max. The lead sound is just very forgiving. And even though I have the gain on max, there's really not that much noise happening. The two channels, they don't really differ that much, maybe a little bit, but you can set them to sound basically the same. So you can go either for having, you know, a clean sound and a distorted sound. You can have a crunch sound and a lead sound, or just full balls on two crush sounds if you want. So, I mean, it's a lot of possibilities, just saying. Okay, we have to go with the clean setting, sorry. That's a great sound right there. But you know, sorry, I'm Ola. I need to play distorted. Okay, I'm gonna try the different cab simulations right now. So there's a knob here on the back so you can set the different cab IRs. For individual channels, so I can't hear it, but I'm recording it, so let's just see. So the cool thing with this, that it has the cab clone built in, is that you can pull the speaker cable from the amplifier. Usually with a tube power amplifier, that would be a problem, you know? But this has an internal load in here, so you can use this without a speaker. It's a full-blown tube amplifier that you can use without a speaker, and you don't need a power attenuator or, you know, a reactive load box or something like that. So that's definitely something I would welcome into the modern era of amplifiers right there. So that's a good call. So I have one thing I want to do, and that is to plug in an active pickup into this thing. So I'm switching guitars. This guitar right here has Fishman Fluence Modern, which is an active pickup. Okay. You also have a power wattage switch here, so you can switch down to 50 and down to 20 watts as well. So let's just try that out. I've been playing at 100 watt this whole time. And then I'm going to show the Bold versus Variac switch right there. That's 100 watt. 50. 20. It still sounds good, but it does sound a little bit flatter than the 100 watt. The 100 watt is just balls out everything. Shit, man. Okay, crush, full on gay. Dial back the gain a little bit on the crunch channel, you get a super tight thrash sound. Let's try the Variac setting. So this is the Bold setting. Variac. It said in the manual that the Variax setting would be a little bit more scooped in the mids and that you might need to return some mids into the sound, but I'm liking it like it is. Shit, man. There it is. That's the Mesa Rectifier Badlander for you right there. And I think it sounds absolutely smashing. They basically took all the good things about the Rectifier, which is a really old design, by the way, from, you know, the beginning of the 90s. And they just took it to the next step, basically. You know, making it a little bit more catered to, you know, the modern Mel sounding guy who would need a little tighter low end, more saturated tone. It's just there, man. And with like the cab clone back there, it also has a buffered effects loop. I forgot to say that. But it's just, it just makes a lot of sense for a Mesa amplifier today in this day and age right here. They're finally kind of catching up a little bit. It makes me very nostalgic because it has that rectified tone, but it just sounds so much more crushing. So I'm just incredibly happy right now. This has been really, really awesome. Guys, if you like this video, please maybe consider putting a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video. How about that? Thank you.